Hello there, and welcome to Fulfillment.com's e-commerce education vlog. My name is AJ Yeager with PraxisMetrics.com, and I'm going to be your host today. So over the next 5 minutes, I want to go over what is, I believe, is to be the number one mistake that 90% of e-commerce brands are making when they're tracking their revenue online. I've worked with a lot of brands in the world, over 150 different brands in e-commerce and their data. So I'm coming from a lot of experience here, and this continues to come up like 99% of the time. So marketing without data is like driving with your eyes closed. I hope you agree with me on that. We can't steer the ship if we don't know our numbers. So today I'm going to go over three things. One is the actual biggest mistake when it comes to tracking e-commerce data. Number two is exactly what UTMs are and how they can take your marketing data to the next level, and how to build a UTM link in the most effective way so you can utilize them in your business. So one of the biggest mistakes is assuming that everything is tracking in your business, okay? What I mean is that all these different applications you're using are not tracking exactly what you may need. And I mean that by out-of-the-box software limitations. Some of the apps like Shopify, what you may be using, are, yes, tracking certain things automatically. But there are other softwares out there that are not tracking the fields that you need ultimately to answer your business questions. The technology is just not set up properly. SOPs may not have been followed by your team when setting these up and getting all the extra custom values filled out. And also, some of these platforms are lacking UIDs, which are unique identifiers. Email is a big one. Address, phone number, you know, exact name. We need something to make sure that we tell the whole story of the data. And many of these don't tie it together, and they don't work together. Google Analytics. I mean, I know many of you probably use it. Some of you may hate it. Some of you may love it. But it is one of the best free tools out there. It does not come set up the right way. Putting code on your website does not handle everything you need. Most people think it's set it and forget it, meaning they set it, they install it, and they're like, oh, good, I don't have to deal with it, and feel like they never have to log in there. Now, I don't recommend logging in there because it's not actually a really good dashboard. Unless you are trained to use it, it does not work the way that you want to, especially for business owners and marketing teams. It's too complicated. Now, this is all about ROI. I want to make sure that you can get ROI out of this training and what I'm going to teach you. Now, the number one mistake is not properly using organized UTMs for all of your marketing efforts online, okay? We've got to be able to prove ROI from all the different channels we're using, and that is super important. And this is very, very detailed, and I think many companies get lazy and or don't follow a certain structure. UTMs stand for Urchin Tracking Mechanism or Module. I won't go into the history, but it's a very simple term. It's a free link that you can create. All it is a parameter. It is a encoded suffix that you append and add to your URL. And it can be quite long and made up of various parameters. But basically, it's providing very specific information about where that link is coming from. And by stringing these parameters together, you're able to track online marketing campaigns with a tremendous amount of detail and granularity. So it may seem simple. You might have heard about these before, but it is literally one of the most powerful ways to track your marketing, sales, and any activity you're doing online. And I highly recommend you listen to this. So here's an example. My buddy Justin Goff is doing a promotion for us. He sent out an email to his list. And if they clicked there or where the other red arrow is, it would be, the link was actually this one. Now it's long, it's ugly, but here's what it means. It tells us six different things. One, the URL. Two, the source. Three, the medium. Four, the campaign name. Five, the content. And then last but not least, the term. Now I'm gonna break these down for you real quick. URL is very simple. That's where you're driving them to, usually gonna be your e-commerce domain. Campaign source. This is where the clicks are coming from. Is it a search engine? Is it another specific site? Is it from maybe even a newsletter that was sent out for you? This could be a lot of different things. Campaign medium is how the link was presented to them. Search end result, pay-per-click ad, email, affiliate link, whatever that may be. This is a very important part. Social media, there's a lot of different ways that you can add in medium, but it's really different for each business. Campaign name. Here, let me move my video up here. Campaign name is the marketing campaign that the link belongs to. Traditionally, this is done in succession of campaigns, like a Black Friday sale. Campaign content is the specific part of a marketing campaign that got them to take action. This is very optional. You don't have to use it, but it's good for testing sometimes ad copy, A-B split tests between emails or other things. campaign term, the keyword used in pay-per-click advertisements that generate the click and the subsequent visitor, or what specific words were clicked in an email. This is, again, optional. You can make this whatever you want to. I'll show you how I did it. Next is, so basically ours was the one above was Justin Goff. So we know who it was. He was an affiliate. The campaign that he was specifically sending out that week, and that again, that it was Justin Goff email. That way we just made sure. But this is very simple because we know the affiliate and we know what relationship it is and how he sent it out. Now there are different ones he sent, and the campaign term we changed later to include email one, email two, email three, email four, etc. So the website URL is simply the website we're tracking, right? The campaign source examples for you to use in the future are Google, Facebook, Twitter, the affiliate or affiliate name, Bing, AdRoll, etc. You can change that however you want to. So these are examples for source. Here's some examples for medium: CPC, cost per click, email, social post, affiliate, referral. And you're going to come up with your own structure. I don't have time to go through all that today, but this is just some quick examples. Campaign, summer sales, social, and then the date. The specific name of the product or a promo code. Also content, email subject lines, controller variation, content A, content B. For term, multiple links inside of an email, different actual number of links. You can put link number one, link number two, actual keywords, or other further things that you could use to describe what you're doing in that marketing activity. So when you should not use UTMs, let me move my face again. This is not using what you should not do. Never put a UTM tag or a campaign variable on an internal link. You're not doing this on your website. This is all external, outside, driving to you. Do not use UTMs when creating internal links on your own internal website. I just said that. If you start using UTMs to link to various parts of your website, you can artificially multiply session counts. This means that you're going to double up or triple up the traffic coming through Google Analytics, and you do not want to corrupt any of your data. We do not want bad data. So to wrap up and give you a few action steps, the only way you can know the true ROI of your online marketing activities is by using UTMs on every single specific online activity you're doing. It doesn't cost anything. It doesn't matter. It's just a matter of taking the time to do it. So there is a cost internally to pay somebody to do this, but it is so worth it. And you're going to have to make mistakes along the way and figure out a system that works for your company. There is a way to go ahead and use these. You can use trackfunnels.com, or you can just go create these inside of Google's tool by itself. Sit down with your team and map out your hierarchy. Have a whiteboarding session to get very clear on each of those six different parameters, how you're going to use it in the future with your marketing channels. Determine a way to stay organized, keep it in a spreadsheet, or use something like trackfunnels.com that we created for free, or choose one campaign. I want you to just choose one campaign right now and begin immediately, okay? UTMs can take your marketing to a whole new level. All the channels and analytics tools out there work with UTMs. For the most part, 95-90% of them will pass UTMs through. And then you can use UTMs to have better data in all of your marketing campaigns. And you can use this data to track return on investment for anything and everything you're doing. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you have any questions, go ahead and let me know. And I'll go ahead and answer anything in the comments. Thank you so much.